Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier, and in our this particular video we are going to discuss how we can form clusters from dendrogram in hierarchical clustering. So in my previous video I have discussed one simple use case of hierarchical clustering, like clustering the electronic goods. Okay, so here this particular example, as you can see, like J2 core, A71, Galaxy A51, Galaxy A21, different products of Samsung are clustered one particular group which is given name as Samsung. Okay, but this is not what actually happens in case of dendrogram, because dendrogram is binary cluster. Here one particular parent cannot have more than two child, okay, in case of dendrogram. Anyway, just this for example I have shown you. So we have seen that a hierarchical clustering method works via grouping data into a tree of clusters. Now the main goal of our unsupervised learning algorithm is clustering similar kind of things, not getting the dendrogram, right? Dendrogram is one kind of visualization, well and good, but our main intention is grouping similar kind of things. Okay, like we have seen for k-means algorithm, like here we have seen some points randomly scattered in 2D plane. First of all, we assume that they are individual clusters. Then we started clustering them. Okay, closest pair we started clustering, and corresponding to that dendrogram we started plotting. Okay, see, eventually we are getting only one cluster. Now these total points A, B, C, D, E, F can be clustered into two different groups, can be clustered into three different groups, can be clustered into five different groups. We don't know what about that. Because in case of k-means algorithm, we have tried to find out the best possible cluster value for our dataset using elbow curve. But here there is no such option is present. But we have the dendrogram, and we know that dendrogram, this is one link. The gap between these two link is basically distance. And this distance, the distance between two links we can use for getting the idea of total number of clusters which should be present in our this particular data set. So these are basically links. These horizontal lines are nothing but links, because they are joining similar kind of structures or similar kind of groups. And there is one more term, height. What is height? Height is basically height of each link. Like this is the height of this link, this is the height of this link, for this link this is the height, for this link this is the height, for this link this is the height. Okay, and you can clearly conclude one very simple thing from these particular heights. That is, if the height between two links is very less, then the gap or dissimilarity between those two clusters are basically very less. Like here, if you consider C and the cluster formed by DEF, C cluster formed by DEF is here and C is here. So the gap, height is this one and this height is this one, the gap is very less. And from the data set also you can clearly see that the gap between C and DEF cluster is very less. They are not much very separated, okay, not very much separated, right? So if the height gap or height difference is small, we can conclude that there is a less difference in between those two clusters. So here same thing I have taken, a link that is approximately the same height as the link below, it indicates that there is no distinct division between the objects joining at this level of the hierarchy. Like here, DEF cluster and C cluster don't have much difference, because you can see here from the picture itself that those don't have much difference, and from the dendrogram you can see that the height between this link, height of this link and this link are very small. Okay, if you consider this link, the below link, just below of this particular link is this one, which is having small height. Okay, these links are said to exhibit a high level of consistency, right? Consistency, simply you can feel why high level of consistency, because much similarity is present in between those. Because the distance between the objects being joined is approximately the same as the distance between the objects they contain. Okay, that means the D and EF, what is contained already in the cluster, having less difference with C. That's why they are having lesser height difference, right? Otherwise their height difference will be more, right? On the other hand, a link whose height differs noticeably from the height of the links below, it indicates that objects joined at this level in the cluster tree are much further apart from each other than their components were when they were joined. Okay, simply what it indicates, see AB joined cluster, here it was present, and CDEF joined clusters, here they were present. Now the gap between this link, this is the link joining AB cluster and CDEF cluster, right? See, this is the height of this, and just below this particular link there are these links which is comparatively of very much smaller height compared to this original link, that is this length. Okay, so it clearly indicates there is a huge gap between AB cluster and CDEF cluster, which you can clearly see from the cluster in all our 2D data set also, right? So this concept we can use for determining what is the best possible value of the cluster we can form in our data set. And here comes the concept inconsistency. How we'll calculate? In this method, the clustering or a division in the data set, division in the clustering is nothing but division in data set, right? We divide into multiple groups. Like for K-means, I have shown you customers can be divided into 5 different groups majorly. Like one with low income and low spending, one with high income, high spending, one with high income, low spending, one with low income, high spending, and one with medium income, medium spending, like that. So we are dividing our customer in a shopping mall into different clusters. So clustering is nothing but division of a data set. And how it is computed? By comparing the height of each link in a dendrogram with the average height of neighboring links below it in the dendrogram. Below it, very very important, not all the links, below that particular link present in the dendrogram. So if I simply say, using this particular example, the test case I have already shown you in my previous video, suppose you want to calculate inconsistency for this particular link. Okay, this is one link, right? Now if you want to calculate inconsistency for this link, or you can say this is as whole link, so what we'll be doing, we'll be comparing this particular link height with the link height below it. So for this link below, only one link is present, which is this one, and this link height is this one. Okay, so what will be my inconsistency for this particular link? That is this link height, suppose this is H1, and this link height, suppose this is H2. So the gap or the difference in between these two heights will be the inconsistency factor for this. Suppose for this link you are going to consider the inconsistency factor. How will be calculating? So this link height is this one, and suppose this is H3. And below this link, there are two links. This is this one, which is having height H1, and this is this one, which is having a high height H2. We can take average of those two, H1 plus H2 by 2, and that we can compare with H3. That difference will be inconsistency factor for this link. For this link, if you want to consider, suppose this particular factor is, suppose, H4. Okay, so what we can, how we can calculate the inconsistency factor? H4 minus H3, H1, H2 average. Okay, that will be inconsistency factor for this. If you want, you can incorporate standard deviation of the inconsistency values also. Like you can calculate like this, H4 minus mean. Okay, and then mean of the heights below the particular link. Okay, divide by the standard deviation. But this is also one possible way. But there is one concept which is very important, you should understand it very clearly. Suppose I am having one link here also. Okay, just consider one link here, like two elements are present, which is connected with this link, and this link is going like this. Okay, now when you are considering the inconsistency factor for this particular link, you should not consider this height. Okay, why? You may think why, because here in this statement clearly written, below we will have to consider height of neighboring links below the dendrogram. Okay, below in the dendrogram. So this particular set is not coming below this particular link. Below this particular link, what are the links coming? This one and this one. Not this one. This is in separate link, right? So we will not consider this one, right? I hope you have understood this. So here you can see, for a huge data set, if you consider dendrogram, it will look like this. In MathWorks, from MathWorks documentation, I have taken this. Here you can see, if you compute, suppose for this link you are computing inconsistency factor. So height is this one, and you can clearly understand that if you take the average of heights of all the links present below this particular link, the gap or the difference will be very less. So for this particular link, inconsistency factor will be very less, right? Because the gap between the height of this particular link and the average of all the links below it are comparatively less, because you can see that the gap is very less. But if you consider, suppose, this link, okay, and the average of height of all the links below this particular link, and you calculate the difference, that is inconsistency factor, then you will be having high inconsistency factor for this. So here I have written that the relative consistency of each link in a hierarchical cluster tree can be quantified and expressed as inconsistency coefficient. This is our main interest. The value compares the height of the link in a cluster hierarchy with the average height of the links below it. As I have told you, links that join distinct clusters have a high inconsistency coefficient. Links that join indistinct clusters have a low inconsistency coefficient. Okay, like as I have told you, for this link, see, you can clearly understand, if this is a cluster of my hierarchical clustering and this is another cluster, the difference in between these two clusters are very less. Okay, so that as a result, eventually what is happening, these particular links or these links having low inconsistency coefficient, because its own height is almost comparable with the average height of the below part. Okay, that's what the main point. All right, so now how you can calculate the inconsistency factor and how you can know what is the optimal cluster value, how many clusters we need to form from this inconsistency factor? Simple. Intuitively, you can clearly understand that if we are able to calculate the inconsistency factor for all the links, then whatever maximum value we will be getting, suppose I am telling for this link I am getting maximum inconsistency factor, then it is quite clear that this particular link is joining some clusters which are having a huge difference, right? So what we'll be doing, we'll be first calculating which link is having maximum inconsistency coefficient, and we'll be taking threshold just somewhat below, like 0.01 or 0.1 amount below that particular link. Like here we have taken one threshold, and the threshold, based on the threshold, now we can cluster. Like here it is cutting, here it is cutting, here it is cutting, three cuts. So we can say majorly three different clusters it is forming. Like here you can see this is one major cluster, this is one set of major cluster, this is one set of major clusters. So our main intention is finding this threshold. And how we can calculate this threshold? Simple. As I have told you, calculate the maximum inconsistency coefficient and then take somewhat below of that, because if you take that same inconsistency factor, then you will be getting that link itself. So just somewhat below you need to go, and then they take that as threshold for clustering. And whatever cut you will be getting, this is the conventional way. This is one cluster may be formed here, this may be one cluster, and here this whole set may be one cluster. Okay, and here I suggest you, strongly suggest you, to go through this particular documentation in hierarchical clustering. Okay, I'll be posting this link in the description box. In my next video, I'll be showing you how you can perform inconsistency coefficient and calculate the optimal value of cluster, and using that you can cluster, implement clustering on supervised learning in MATLAB. But please check this, because here all the things whatever I have discussed is written in an accurate way. Here you can see inconsistency factor and some different options, like column 1 is mean of the height of the links including the included in the calculation. Like as I have told you, the mean difference or mean of the all the heights below the particular link and the link height difference we take. Then this is for first column. For second column in the inconsistency factor, we are including the standard deviation of all the links also. Okay, that is whatever link we are considering and the mean of all the links below, for all those we are calculating standard deviation, and that also we are considering. For third one, number of links including included in the calculation. Like here only one link is included, one link, three link, two link, how many links you are considering. Okay, you may tell that suppose consider this example. Okay, so here what was our actual figure? See, okay, two links. So suppose consider this one. Okay, so suppose you want to calculate the inconsistency factor for this link, then how you can choose how many links you want to consider. Like suppose you want to consider two links, so it will go to two level below. So one level is, if we just go one level below, we will be getting this link, and suppose here one more link was present, this link. So this is one level we have went down, and if I adjust for two levels, so it will consider this also, but it will not consider this one. But if you go to three level, then it will consider all this. Okay, like that. How many levels of links you want to consider, that also you can give as input and perform. All right, the coding part I'll be discussing in my next video. This is all for this video. Thank you for watching.